Namaskaram, Nanavinita Pandey, Keralam, Telanam. So, I love Kerala and right now I'm in Kerala. There's a beautiful place near Wayanad known as 700 and my Jeep driver, he asked me to go for this beautiful view and I took the natural bath. So, before I tell you some other important things related to this, I must tell you I love Kerala and if you just see the beauty, you yourself will fall in love with Kerala. Chetak. Lush green. If you read literature and you have the, you know, senses to feel it, you will fall in love. So, literature is life, life is literature. And in this video, I want to tell you how to read literary criticism. A lot of students, they asked me how to start criticism, which should be the first writer, how to read selective writers, are we supposed to read each and every doctrine of the writers, rules and principles given by them. So first of all, I must tell you, if you are reading literary criticism for the sake of research, PhD, then obviously you're supposed to go in depth of maximum things. But if you're reading it for the competitive exams, I suggest you to divide the writers of criticism in two parts. The legislative criticism writers like Plato, Aristotle, Horace, Dryden, Ben Jonson, Alexander Pope, Matthew Arnold, T.S. Eliot, or you may also go for the liberal writers. The liberal writers are the romantic writers. And here you can go for Longinus. Then after Longinus, you can have Keats, Shelley, Wordsworth, Coleridge, and few others. So once you are done with these things, remember, the classical tradition writers, Plato, Aristotle, they have talked about just one common thing. They talk about the great emotions. When you have great emotions, you talk something very great. So great emotions, great expression, and great style. The great style is related to the writing standard. How are you choosing your words? What is your language standard? How are you communicating those great emotional messages to a very big crowd in a great way? So they commonly follow these three kind of special points. The great emotions, the great expression, and the great, you know, and the great style. Remember the style like Milton's The Grand Style, Arnold's Great Style. Liberal writers, romantics were very much liberal. They were of the view that just feel it and choose any medium, just speak. Like Wordsworth, he says there's emotions like poetry. So it's something, it's a spontaneous overflow of powerful emotions and recollected in tranquility. So in short, when you read literary criticism, it's really good if you started with Plato. Aristotle should be number two. After this, go for Horace. Then go for Longinus. Then go for Ben Jonson. Then Dryden. After Dryden, you should go for Alexander Pope. After Alexander Pope, you can go for Matthew Arnold directly because he is still in the literary tradition. So we are not following all the writers chronologically because we are avoiding Coleridge and Keats and Shelley and other writers. So go for Matthew Arnold. And after Arnold, T.S. Eliot is the modern critic and modern writer who actually is also known as a bridge between literary criticism and literary theory. Once you are done with these writers, it will help you to understand those concepts because these writers have talked about the common things again and again. So they are talking about the same thing. Somebody calls it objective correlative. Somebody calls it the relation with the life, emotions and nature itself. Like Keats calls it negative capability. Eliot says it's theory of impersonality. Moreover, if you remember, Horace and other writers, they have talked about imitation. Matthew Arnold calls it the stone method. So once you go for a proper listing of these writers, you will find out the right way of reading this. Now, are we supposed to go in the depth? No. But make sure you have some points written. Like he talks about this. His views towards poetry is this, his views towards criticism is this, his views towards life is this, and these are the rules and regulations mentioned by that writer. So that's how you have to make a rule. And now, I won't be able to sum up a lot of other things because my driver is also giving me some gestures. So, this is Vineet Pandey in Kerala, and I must tell you, do not just read literature for the sake of reading, for the sake of some exam, and for the sake of some money to survive according to the society. Live the life. It's once in a life. You will have a real life to live. And please, apply literature in your life. This is Vineet Pandey from beautiful, beautiful, beautiful Kerala, God's own country.